ABC One. By the way, so did Congressman Louie Gohmert. Take a look at this tense exchange.
And you have come in here and said, I have no bias. And you do it with a straight face. And I watched you in the private testimony you gave. And I told some of the other guys, he is really good. He's lying. He knows. We know he's lying. And he can probably pass a polygraph. No, the disgrace,
Mr.
what this man has done.
The gentleman from Texas will suspend for a moment.
There is the disgrace. And it won't be recaptured anytime soon because of the damage you've done to the justice system. And I've talked to FBI agents around the country. You've embarrassed them. You've embarrassed yourself. And I can't help but wonder, when I see you looking there with a little smirk, how many times did you look so innocent into your wife's eye and lie to her about this?
Mr. Chairman, this is outrageous.
Credibility of a witness
shame
always
on you. Mr. Chairman, please.
Mr. Chairman, this is intolerable. Harassment
with
witness.
What's wrong with that? You need your medication.
It is clear, it is obvious to every American with common sense. Peter Strzok definitely has an unfaithful relationship with the truth. Now, without a doubt, this is the greatest case of cognitive dissonance that I've ever seen in my life. He's out of touch with reality. He thinks only he knows what's right for America. It couldn't be more obvious. The poster child of what we now know as a deep state, thinking he knew better and knows better than we smelly Trump supporters. But predictably, in order to deflect, he used an all-too-common tactic of the left, launched into some attack, into some of the, quote, extreme folks on TV. And I have a response, just like